Okay, so let's get started with finding out the contact details. So let's suppose if I'm giving a search directly on a LinkedIn, let's start with the LinkedIn. I'll just go search for people. These are all my connections. I'll say people who are not in my connection, because if someone is already in my connection, like if I say his profile, he's already in my first degree connection. Whichever the profile I pick of my first degree connections, their contact detail is something are visible to me. I just have to click on the first degree and see the contact info. So here I can see their contact details. Unless the person is not in the first degree connection, unless we are not connected to the person directly, we will not be able to see their contact details. Okay, so I'm just searching with the first degree connection, and I'm regularly hiring for software engineers. So I'll just go say people, all filters. I give for current company, Microsoft, LinkedIn, Google. Outside, I need people from Bangalore. Then I go with software engineer or software developer. So this is a very simple search. What we have given LinkedIn, these are the search filters in LinkedIn free version. I'm not even searching on recruiter. So most of the times we miss these many filters directly from the LinkedIn free version. So I can search by first degree connection, second degree connection, or third degree. No, third degree is not visible to me. So let me just go for the first degree. And skills, I've not given anything. Basically, a software engineers from Google, LinkedIn, or Microsoft would do for my real-time requirements. So these are all the people who are in my first degree connection. 47 people are in my first degree connection who are working at these companies as a software engineers. And whoever is in my first degree connection, I'll be able to see that. Contact details. I just have to go to the profile and click on contact info. If someone has updated their phone number also, we'll be able to see their phone numbers and additional detail. So this will basically, some people keep it confidential, some people keep it open, some people keep themselves as an open network profile so that anybody can connect with them. So basically 99.99% people at least give their email IDs visible to the other LinkedIn network people who are in the first degree connection. Okay, now we go back to the search and we go for second degree now. So from the first degree, we are making it to second degree. Okay. Now I got 503 profiles who are in my second degree working at Google or Microsoft, based out of Bangalore and who are software engineers. And let me see in case if I can give an example. Let's suppose now Anmol Singh Jaggi. So there are two types of profile. One, a normal profile, and the another one, open network profile. If you see this badge, okay, that's nothing but those are the open network profiles as well. The premium profiles who has upgraded to the premium version of it. So let's see what's the difference. So in second degree connection, if I go and see their contact details, I would not be able to see their contact details. Okay. He is in my second degree, but he is a premium and open network profile, additionally given additional links. I can go through those additional links and find out the contact details from there. GitHub portfolio. Okay, so most of the profiles, most of the time, what you see with this particular batch, it's easy to find their contact details. It's still logged in. Let's not go. So here is his GitHub profile. And he works at LinkedIn, but I do not have his contact details. So we'll find it out how to find the contact details for GitHub as well, GitHub profiles as well. Okay, so now finding out people in my second degree or finding out people in my third degree and their contact detail. So we have a number of tools available in market like Hirechuel or SalesQL, email finder. There are a lot of tools. Basically what we need to do is like we just have to go to the app store, then go to the web store. Email finder. Okay, so you see here we have Snowvio, LinkedIn email finder called Adapt, email extractor. So there are so many tools available, but some of the best of the tools I would say are like Hirechuel, SalesQL. Let me just go for the reason I'm saying SalesQL, because it gives us, here it is already downloaded, because it gives us 100 inventories free, wherein the other portals which will give us maybe a 5 or maybe a 10 or something like that, but wherein the SalesQL and which other tool, Adapt, but the most efficient, what I find after doing the research on all the various tools, I find Hirechuel and the SalesQL. Hirechuel is paid, where we get only 5 email for free. RocketReach is paid, where we get only 5 email for free. But if I want to see more people contact detail, then I need to upgrade. So that is where I'm coming from, SalesQL, which will give us to identify 100 emails. So we just go here to the App Store and search for SalesQL. It's already downloaded in my extensions. So he's in my second degree. Let's go for a SalesQL. I'm not going to show anything which has a paid upgradation. I'm going to show you which we can access for free. So here is his email ID. He's in my second degree. Again, we go for SalesQL. Deepak Agrawal. We can create a project and add people. So here is his email ID. Okay. Now second hack. So better example to give this profile's example. Okay. If you see his contact info. Okay. This is his LinkedIn URL. linkedin.com/.in/Agrawal1084. Even in this also, Anmol Singh Jaggi. Okay. So LinkedIn has two different types of URLs. Let me try to show you. One is predefined. The other is we have modified it. Okay, so predefined goes with first name, last name, and some alphanumeric number. That is the default URL of individual profiles when they have created their LinkedIn profiles. If you see, this is also kind of a predefined. Okay, but it also gives us an option to edit the public URL. Okay, so many people edits this public URL, and in case It basically a ratio of if we see 10 profiles, maybe two or three profiles would have edited their LinkedIn URL because a lack of awareness. But generally, if it is edited, something like this, then pick this part, only this user ID after .in. Just take this particular part, copy it, come down to your Gmail, compose, and try to see in case if he has a Gmail ID. Okay, and then we just slightly hover on it. If you see the pic like this, okay, that means this email ID is existing. A pic like this, or in some cases you will be able to see first name dot last name at Gmail or something like that, you'll be able to see. Let me take this part, Anmol Singh Jaggi, which looks very similar name in India, so might not be. It's just that he wanted to create something like that, his LinkedIn URL pattern. Let me see. So yeah, these do exit. Okay. So earlier we had Google Plus. In Google Plus, it was pretty much easy to identify the individuals also, but that Google Plus is gone now, because I used to get the Google Plus profile photo also over here, and I used to get the option of view the Google Plus profile. But now the Google Plus has gone, so that's reason it's a bit difficult for me to give a particular match to match. But unless this is something unique, okay, Agrawal 1084, that is something unique. This is something common. So for common thing, I would not take a chance. But if I want to verify it, if this is the common email ID, this email ID is of the same person of Anmol Singh Jaggi. So there are two different ways, because here I see for him, which we have verified, we have used SalesQL, and also in SalesQL also it's giving the same email ID that which exists. But wherein in this case, SalesQL gives me a different email ID. Okay, and here he has a different thing. So as he's a software engineer, I'll just try to see in case if he's somewhere on the web. Okay, Anmol Singh Jaggi, he's on Twitter, and Twitter URL is also something different. Anmol Jaggi, he would have not got that Anmol Singh Jaggi Twitter URL, so he has made it just Anmol Jaggi. So he's also on ZubaCorp. I'll say his GitHub profile. Is it the same Anmol Singh Jaggi? Anmol Singh Jaggi, he's working at LinkedIn. Yes, he is on GitHub. He's the one, Anmol Singh Jaggi. And this is his github.io profile. Let me just go back. Let me not get into that. This is his LinkedIn profile. Let me see his Twitter profile, if it's the same. No. No, I don't think so. So let me not take a chance on our Twitter profile. ZubaCorp, Anmol Singh Jaggi registered. Okay, so he has registered the company. Which company did he register? Following is their current and past directorship holding. Okay, so there are a number of Anmol Singh Jaggis. Blue Smart. The reason I was saying for the Zubakov, I'll tell you later in this call itself. We'll come back to that. But we got his Git profile. So let's not go with this. Let's take only a LinkedIn. So first thing what we have done, it was edited part. We have taken this part and used in a Gmail. Though this email ID is existing at the, but the name is very much common in India. So that's the reason we are not taking a chance. Otherwise we know what is his email by using SalesQL. But what if SalesQL also do not show us? Then we have gone to his GitHub profile. We got his GitHub profile. After going through his GitHub profile, we'll run up an API part. This is his user ID of GitHub profile. From here you can take, or you can take it from here, which is below the name, you have their user IDs. If he has done some of the contributions, repositories, and the projects on a GitHub, and this is the URL pattern of finding out from the APIs of GitHub. Okay, so Anmol Singh Jaggi, as soon as we give his URL, we got this page. And from here, we are finding, okay, Anmol Singh Jaggi, we have his official email ID. He's working at LinkedIn. And we got his official email ID at first place. Okay. And anmollj.65, we have his personal email ID also. Like this, anmol.65@gmail. So what we're trying to do manually is something SalesQL has automated the process, and that is how this particular tool has been built. So now we are going manually one by one to the different websites like GitHub or from the Gmail or from Live. We are going one by one. But wherein, what SalesQL is doing, SalesQL is basically SalesQL or HireQL, such kind of a site, email finder sites. What they're doing is like, they have attached a code to it. They have made a software in such a way that this manual process, they automate it and get the results. So that's it, nothing else. Okay, this is one way. What was his email ID? Let me just go to his. Okay. Now, second thing, I'll just go. I'll get into email parameter. This is basically one of the Excel driven by first name, middle name, last name, and domain. So if you're really desperate to find that one particular email ID of the person, then you can take this approach because it will take time. So LinkedIn domain, obviously I know that is. So these are all the techniques, may not be for the Indian market, but if you're working for the European, and so I understand in European sourcing, sometimes you are really desperate about finding out the contact details. So that is where you can apply this formula. So what does this do is like first name, middle name, and last name as well domain. With a combination of all these three, four, it has created first name at domain, then last name at domain, first name, last name at domain, first name dot last name at domain, initial of first name, then last name at linkedin.com domain. Okay, so that's how it has made a various combinations and trying to come up with the various email ID formats. And also it shows here which are the formats mostly existing, like underscores, then the dash used by hyphen, and then first name dot middle name, backwards, basic, simple, and all. Then I take this one particular part, maybe the first hit would be, I'll try with something anmolsingh.jaggi@linkedin.com. I'm trying to verify. So if I use it here, so Gmail will understand Gmail server. Gmail will understand Google server. Likewise, Microsoft will understand Microsoft clubbed LinkedIn server, because there's an integration between Microsoft and LinkedIn now. Microsoft has purchased LinkedIn. So there's an integration between these two databases. So Microsoft will understand LinkedIn as well as Microsoft its own server. But if I'm trying to see anmol.jaggi@linkedin.com, I would be able to get this, and which is Google is not verifying it. But if I go here, I'll say create a new contact. I'll keep this as it is, whatever. Only the contact information I'll use. And I'll say create. So this is outlook.live.com, basically a web version of Outlook. You will have to create a login details. Sometimes people may not have it. If you don't have it, just create a login details and utilize it for a week of time. I'm already logged in, so it will get me to this page only. After coming to this particular page, I'll come here to the people. And these are the people which I added just, which I added. So now, if I added this person, okay, I just kept AL and anmolsingh@linkedin.com. This LinkedIn logo is coming because I've given linkedin.com. So that's the reason this LinkedIn logo is coming. If I give microsoft.com, then as I told, Outlook will understand Microsoft and the LinkedIn both servers. So it coming Microsoft logo here. So similarly, now I'll see in case if this email ID is associated with this account or not. We just go here, we have created a contact, we clicked on a new contact, then we give a something, but the most important what we gave is an email ID, email address. After giving an email address, this contact got generated. Now we'll click here on a LinkedIn. Okay, so this is not existing. So let me take a second bet. This will get disconnected. Zoom call will get disconnected after 10 minutes. So please use the same login details and log in again. Let me take this second bet. Again, I go create a new contact. And say create. So I come here and click on LinkedIn. So it's still giving me something else. So in case if it is a dot to dot match, let me just directly give the example which we have already identified from here. Ajaggi. Still not. Maybe he has not uploaded his official email ID. So let's take a second bet up with here. Anyhow, we got his email ID from here. But still, I just wanted to show you as an example. Aman Gupta is different. You'll have to see his email and the name over here. So we got the email IDs, but now we are cross-verifying it. Generally, this is already verified from the GitHub itself, but I'm just giving an example, this example, because in case if you have some other email IDs which you wanted to come back and verify. One we can verify here like this. Why it is not syncing? Okay. That's strange. Let me come back here because it's a Gmail ID. So here it is. So using Gmail, we have verified it. So there are basically various ways. So first focus, what we're doing is like, as soon as we open a LinkedIn profile, we're trying to see in case if it is the user profile is predefined URL or the person has modified it. If the person has modified it, we're taking this part, adding Gmail to it and trying to verify in a Gmail server, Google server. Second thing, similarly, what we're doing, if the person is existing on GitHub, then we are using api.github.com/user, this particular API part, and trying to get the email IDs from there. Now, there are people who might be existing on a GitHub. GitHub or HackerRank. So we are just giving a simple X-ray search. X-ray search session will be a separate. Again, I'll be going to take. So if you see, I'm not going to in depth of this particular search, but why I have run this. It will be covered in one of the X-ray search sessions. But otherwise, I got some 6,000 people who are coding on Java and located in Bangalore, and these are all their URL patterns. So we basically take this data, and here directly I do not have any option to see their contact details if I'm logged in also. So we just go, we just take that part at the rate gmail.com. So the beauty of this, most of these such kind of a coding forums will ask us to sign up with the Google. Let's suppose if you're new to GitHub or HackerRank or something like that, and if you're trying to sign up, even the email verifier site, whichever the sites are asking to sign up using Google or Facebook. And 80% of people, I assume, they use Google to sign up. So what happens is their user profile, the URL pattern of their user profile, whatever the text is before @Gmail, that becomes their user ID, like this one. If he has signed up by using Google, okay, so whatever the text which is before their before @gmail.com, that particular text will become their user IDs. So it's very much easy to find people from that particular site and then coming back to the Google server and verifying it on a Gmail server. Earlier we had a G+, it was pretty much easy on that. So if you see, in some names we are getting their profile pics, or some names we are not getting as it is. But if you see, there is some slight difference. You have given this Animesh Bhatia 11 at Gmail. But if you see any of the email below changing that animesh.bhatia 11 is coming, that means that particular email ID is existing with the Gmail server. If you see profile pic, well and good, that is the best part of taking a verification. Okay, now for this Parash, we'll see an additional part. So he is PRAHARSH9@gmail. So I'll go for in URL and I'll see where all this person is available, because his URL of Hacker Earth was Parash9. Now he might be using the same URL on some other sites. I'll just try to verify it by giving in URL Parash, but I see that no, he's not using it. Parash Priyank. Similarly, I can search this name again, going back to LinkedIn, because at least I have some information from here that he is studying at JSS Academy. Yes, this is the profile. He's studying at JSS Academy. Again, I go to his contact. See, in case if something he has mentioned about his GitHub profile or something like that. He's pretty new, maybe he's studying, so that's reason he did not have much of the web presence. He's just practicing on a Hacker Earth. Okay, Bunny19. Let's go here. Come back to Gmail. Yep, that's exist. Similarly, I just go. We'll try to see in case if it is giving now. What's his name? Parash Priyank.